General Dua, do you think that that's a good idea?
Look, Barka, the country is going through a crisis. Army is always there to help. Army does have some infrastructure. And let me put it, you asking me whether it's a good idea? I think the army has already started helping. Army has stepped in several aspects. For instance, in the logistics, the oxygen trains, as we all know, or in the logistic part, the army has already stepped in. Army has opened several of its hospitals apart from setting up this couple of big hospitals for the civil public. It has also opened 50 of its own hospitals where the civilians will be treated along with the soldiers as long as bed capacity is available. So army has stepped in, but all I want to make a point is that we also must remember that military has its own operational role to perform. Whatever be the situation in the country, sad as it is, as an informed citizen, I'm retired now, we all feel the same way, and we are also going through the same thing. But remember that army cannot work from home. Army cannot, it's not a factory that can be shut down. We have an LOC and an LAC, which are active borders. We have to take care of the security needs of the country. It is only in bad weather that the enemy will attack. So, you know, that is where we are, the situation that we're going through. So the field formations also have to be maintained more. My information is a little dated, but there were more than 40,000 soldiers who had been afflicted or who were tested, who were COVID positive. So army has to take care of its own also. In the rear areas, army is helping as it can, whether it is logistics or hospitals. The reservists, all the medical and paramedical staff, the reservists has been recalled. So all I'm trying to say, army is doing the best it can. But please remember, army is also stretched to seams with its own looking after its own. And at the expense of reputation, one last sentence, that we do have to maintain our operational posture on the borders, come what may. We cannot. That's a shop that cannot be closed.
I'd like Colonel Garg maybe to add a little bit on the hands-on problems, Colonel Garg, that may happen, because sources are saying that while DRDO jumbo facilities have been set up, this is creating pressure now on supply lines of drugs and doctors and staff for existing research and referral military facilities, and also that these are just skeletal centers that are being handed over to the military, and like hospitals everywhere else, there aren't people or drugs to actually fuel them. Colonel Garg, if you'd like to speak to this.
Yeah, Barka, thanks for letting me in. And I would like to say that what you are telling us is correct. I have been in the AMC for close to 30 years. And most of the time we have been fighting with our hands behind our back, tied behind our backs, because we never had the resources. Though we have generally been rationalizing resources with the amount of things that we have, we try and put up a good show. However, what is happening is that there are other sources also. Now, we have established a hospital by the so-called DRDO. Now, it is being manned entirely by the army people, by the army personnel. We have doctors, around 150 doctors from the army. The entire paraphernalia is from the army. You can just set up a place and just recall all the army officers and everyone, and they are coming and doing this job. Now look at it from one way. We have a base hospital in Delhi, which has got close to 1,000 beds, which is totally COVID hospital. Out there, officers, men, retired officers, retired men are waiting to get into their own facility. The army doesn't pay you very well. Most of us cannot afford to go to big Tony hospitals. And this is happening. I'm sitting in Dehradun. The commandant of MS Dehradun has done a wonderful job. But you go out there every day, you have got 10 to 12 deaths. Now, where do we... I do a OPD for COVID. My wife does a OPD for COVID. All of us are doing OPDs for COVID. We are looking and helping patients in whichever way. However, we are doing it out of the resources which are for a particular set of people. And yeah, we have got nothing against them. We want them to come. But what is happening is that this kind of thing, when they said that all civilians, the hospitals are being opened up to all civilians, we have had issues in the military hospitals where people have come and demanded beds. Now, how can you demand a bed and get a bed when there is no bed available? And when you look at it, a serving personnel will certainly be a priority, because our job is to make him fit and send him to the front. What General Dua said is perfectly right. This is the time when the enemy is going to attack us, when we are down and out. You can't possibly finish off all our resources, and we've got other sources. There's so many doctors sitting, there's so many doctors available. Let me tell you, the Mrs. Sujata is there, who's been the health secretary. I've read a book also. Let me tell you, we have been looking at the health perspective from a very, very stupid way. We do not have shortage of doctors. Today, you can get an MBBS doctor for 45,000 rupees. My driver gets paid 25,000 rupees.
So, Colonel Garg, you're not very comfortable. You're not very comfortable for this falling. Neither you nor General Dua are very comfortable for this falling on the army. You're saying that might create more problems than it actually solves.
No, we are very comfortable that it comes to the army, but with the resources.
With the resources. General Dua, you want to add quickly to that? Then I want to go to Gautam. He's been waiting to speak in Himanshi then. General Dua, not enough resources?
No, I you know, like Colonel Garg said, the army is doing the best it can, but please remember that army is also stretched to seams. So that is one point. And the fact that army cannot let its guard down, with all these things put together, army, and I just counted out how many hospitals or how many facilities army has actually opened up to the civilians. So please remember, the army is doing the best it can. That's exactly what I want to leave it at.